Hi friends, I'm Larissa, and in this channel I talk all about how you can have a better relationship with your houseplants. So hit the subscribe button and the notification bell if you want to learn how to live in harmony with your plants. So in today's video, we're gonna talk about that season of the year that every plant parent dreads, the winter. I mean, that is if you don't live in a tropical country, because honestly, people couldn't care less about the winter in Brazil. But here in Canada and in North America, Europe, what happened is most of our tropical plants come from tropical climates, and we take those plants and we put inside the houses in the temperate zone. So those plants need some adjustment, and when this time of the year hits, when the temperatures start to go down, it's when they will feel most of the difference. So there is three main factors that you had to deal with as a plant parent when it comes to winter: humidity, light, and temperature. Let's talk about humidity first. So it's not just the temperatures that go down in the winter. The temperatures go down, but the humidity also drops a lot. And this is something that was a shock for me when I moved to Canada, because you know, I come from Brazil, a tropical country, and the weather there is not just really hot, but it's also really humid. It rains a lot, it can pour for 3 days nonstop, especially in the summer. In my first winter here, I had skin problems and my hair was all dry, my nose was bleeding, and I had to adapt to that. So imagine if I was a plant, I would be struggling. Most of the houseplants are used to 50 to even 70% of relative humidity. And during the winter, in a very cold day, the humidity in our houses can drop to 15%. And again, it's not just the plant. For humans, the ideal spectrum of relative humidity is between 40 and 60%. So raising the humidity in your house is good for your plants, but it is also good for your health. And the main way you can do that is by having a humidifier, like the one I have. They are not crazy expensive. You can find this one in Amazon for around 100 Canadian dollars, and I'm gonna link to this specific one down below. But there are also other ways to raise the humidity inside your place. You can use a tray of water with pebbles near your plants, you can use a fountain, or you even can put your plant inside a plastic bag to create like an isolated environment. And we're gonna do a full video about how to raise humidity in your house. But for now, try to measure the humidity in your place using one of those humidity meters and try to keep it above 40%. So another main factor is light. And the days get really short here in North America when it comes to winter. And you know that light is the main ingredient that plants use to stay healthy and grow. So the first thing you want to do here is curb your expectations. Your plants are not likely to grow during the winter season. They may stop growing completely. And if you're fertilizing your plants on a regular basis, now is the time to stop it. Because if the plant is not using the nutrients you put there to grow, those nutrients are just gonna sit there in soil and it can damage your plant. More than that, some plants may even go into dormancy like some alocasias do. So if you have a plant you really like and this plant is this time of the year comes and this plant is gonna drop a lot of leaves turning yellow, leaf loss, just don't toss that plant out yet. The plant may just be going into dormancy and it may come back in spring. But if you notice that your plant is really struggling, or you want your plant to still grow a little during the winter, you can change the lighting situation. So you may want to put your plants closer to the window, or you may use some grow lights to keep that plant growing to those dark days and dark periods. And the third factor that plant parents need to be aware of during the winter is the temperature, of course. And I know most of us are very fortunate to live in places with heating systems. So while it's cold and dreadful out there, inside our homes is still cozy and warm. But that doesn't mean that there are no cold places inside your house, and plants can be really sensitive to that. So even when a plant is really close to a window, sometimes the windows get too cold during the winter, and be mindful of that, especially if the leaves of the plant are touching the glass. They can get damaged by this shock or cold temperature. And also, you may want to notice if your plant is on the way of a cold or a hot draft. For instance, if your plant is close to the front door and this door gets open all the time and this cold wind is coming in, that can damage your leaves and your plant may start declining. Or even if your plant is on the way of the ventilation system and you have hot air coming out of the vents now, your plant may also suffer some shock and start to decline. So be mindful of that. So that's all. That's all you need to know to prepare your plants for the winter. If you like this video, you're also gonna like this one, in which I talk about the 5 things you cannot do if you want to keep your plants alive. Thank you for watching, and I see you soon. Bye!